Hello and welcome to this Mastering Academy video. In this video I talk about the critical balance between sound enhancement and loudness enhancement in the process of audio mastering. The key to a great or failed mastering in the gravitation field of commercial requirements is the proper balance between those two ingredients. In order to visualize this principle, we use two virtual faders. The left one reflects the overall sonic enhancement, we call it sound quality, and the right fader stands for loudness increase. Both faders are in the zero position right in the middle of the fader when we start with mastering. The basic aim of a commercial mastering is to increase the loudness, the right fader, while making sure that the left fader sticks to the positive area above zero, which is unfortunately often not the case. The only way to verify whether we have a positive quality value is by applying loudness compensated A-B comparisons. This means that the louder mastered version is level reduced, for example somewhere in the listening path, in such a manner that it has perfectly the identical level like the original unprocessed version. Level jumps higher than 0.1 dB distract the hearing in such a manner that an objective judgment is impossible due to the effect of the well-known Fletcher-Munson curve of equal loudness. A further important factor for a solid and meaningful comparison is the choice of a proper spot of the recording. It should be a spot with a certain amount of inherent dynamic. Let's say a drum fill, a percussion fill, a spot where one can hear the ghostings of a snare pattern, or simply a dynamically arranged and performed spot of the song. Listen to the subtle changes of sound coloration of transients and the contrast between loud and calm events within the audio. If a percussive event loses impact, you are already on the negative side of the quality scale. The same is true for the case of a loss of contrast. When a dynamic event starts to appear artificial or machine-like, you went too far with the loudness fader. You will not only lose sonic quality, you will also lose musical and emotional quality of the recording. Finally, a good master should sound pleasant and nice. If you listen very, very loud, while masters with a negative quality scale tend to sound harsh, unpleasant and obtrusive. So, back to the balancing principle of our both virtual faders, quality and loudness. As you may have guessed, it is impossible to raise both faders randomly. The more the right loudness fader is raised, the more likely it is that the quality fader falls somewhere below the zero line. I approach it usually this way. At first, I do everything possible to improve and balance the sound without touching the loudness so that I have a positive quality value. The sole aim is to create a great sounding master with a balanced frequency distribution, which translates to a wide range of monitoring systems and situations. I act as if there's no loudness war at all. Not till then I take care of the loudness fader as the second step. I increase loudness while continuously making loudness compensated A-B comparisons with the original in order to make sure to stick to the positive side of the quality fader. I absolutely make sure to not pay loudness with quality. This way I connect two controversial worlds to create a competitive loud master with excellent sound characteristics, which sound finally much better on the radio compared to overcompressed masters. If the focus is too much on loudness increase, one will reach the point rapidly where the quality fader falls below zero and the master sounds worse than the original mix. Unfortunately, this is the case since more than a decade for far more than 90% of all commercial releases. In all these cases, loudness is paid with a currency called sound quality. When defining the right loudness-sound quality balance, consider this. hypercompressed masters lead on a psychoacoustical level to hearing fatigue, headache, loss of concentration, and therefore to a reduced half-life period. Just releases with a good quality loudness balance lasts for years and decades. So make sure to not pay your loudness goals with quality. It will pay off, and the loudness myths are completely based on wrong assumptions and a lack of scientific audio technology knowledge of the decision makers in the music industry. By the way, Tischmeier masterings always have a perfect quality loudness balance. The same is true for all masters done by certified Mastering Academy engineers. The 5-day master course at Mastering Academy is a once-in-a-lifetime event which will change your way of working with audio forever and gives you all the required knowledge to create excellent masters. So that's it for right now. Thank you very much for listening and see you soon here. Bye-bye.